We've been working up here in the Cassowary catchment for a number of years. We found a lot of these waterways had suffered damage through high water flow events. Predominantly the creek banks were being washed away. There was very thin riparian verges. And the farmers were very vocal in letting us know that they were highly concerned about the loss of their productive land.
Over the last 15, 20 years, I've noticed the creeks are getting deeper. There's nowhere where the water can sort of break out and flood the plains like a relief valve, and everything's just concentrated down the river, and it's just causing a lot of damage and erosion.
Yeah, it's important to remember that rivers are dynamic things. They move over time. So the fluvial system, that is creeks and waterways and valleys, are influenced by climate, they're influenced by tectonics. So these are broad scale things, more local things, they're influenced by vegetation and soil types and hydrology and hydraulics. Channel deepening, channel widening, all these processes are natural processes, but they're exacerbated by certain things that we do. It's almost always the case that the erosion is located in areas where the vegetation is absent. And that just goes to show that that vegetation holds the bank together and reduces that likelihood of erosion. A cleared catchment can be likened to a sheet of glass. So if you pour water onto a sheet of glass, it'll run really rapidly off that sheet of glass. Whereas a vegetated catchment can be likened to a piece of shag pile carpet. So if you put a shag pile carpet on an angle and pour a jug of water onto it, it'll slowly move out of that. And so with a vegetated catchment and riparian buffers, it won't get to those peak levels that erode the stream so much.
And when I first met Richard, he was very hesitant around the use of trees.
I wasn't a real tree person until Vanessa done this job, and since we've done that, I've been very happy with it. I'm really, really excited about it. See, when you get the big grass there and the rain comes and you lose a clump of that big grass, it'd take a half a tonne of dirt away from the bank.
Adding vegetation is really the only self-sustaining and long-term mitigation measure for bank erosion. So when we talk about riparian vegetation and revegetation, we're talking about creating a dense, wide, continuous corridor of vegetation. As far as you can go back, the better. We sort of start off with an ideal of around 30 metres, but we understand that, you know, there's production that's required on your land. Something like this was a compromise between Vanessa and Richard, and they came to about 6 to 10 metres, I believe, in most spots.
I've got to sacrifice some ground to get the trees in there. It'll hold a bank. And it's like Rio in a concrete base. It's going to hold the bank, and hopefully it'll be here for years to come. And it's the most economical way to go.
So if you're going to do your own planting, it's probably worth visiting a nursery and talking to them about the types of trees that will be suitable for your waterway.
It takes a community to really build resilience into these waterways.
Plant trees, let them do the work for us. Yeah, the best thing I can do now is preserve and look after them best I can.